Hello and welcome back to Open Source Summit North America 2025. My name is Paul Nashawaty. I cover app dev space and covering all things open source. I am joined today by Alok and Bill. Hey guys, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Great to have you here. Chronosphere is doing a lot of great things, a lot of interesting activity happening, and you're doing things right in my wheelhouse, right? We have the observability space is just, is really starting to grow, really starting to kind of take off. I love the announcements that you're sharing, and you're doing some of this announcement with logs. Let's talk a little bit about that.
Yeah. You want to take that?
Yeah, so what we've done in the last couple of months is release our second, or logging 2.0, you could say, and that means that what we've, you know, as Chronosphere is a product that is excellent at your controlling your data volumes and help giving you insight in data volumes. We hadn't done that for logs yet, so what we're launching is the ability to do that with logs now. Control data volumes, insights into your data volumes with logs.
Well, that, I mean, it sounds really exciting, and I'll tell you why. When I look at my research, I cover day zero, day one, day two, and DevSecOps in my practice, and my day two research really covers all around observability and what's happening in this space. And I found that, you know, the biggest use case for observability is management, like log management, right? And understanding what's happening. And, you know, and then there's things like, you know, APM, NPM, there's tracing, there's all sorts of things that people want to do. But like, when it comes to logs, there's a big factor here that organizations are trying to understand and to take actionable insights against the information that they're running. So Bill, what was the strategic direction here for like why logs? Why logs, why now?
Yeah, I mean logs are the glue for everything, right? I mean, you've mentioned traces, you mentioned metrics, you get alerts that happen that say some things are going on in your environment. The metrics and traces will get you to where and sort of what's changed, but the logs are the glue that help you, right? And so without those, you spend a lot longer, you know, troubleshooting and digging, but they've got to be valuable, they've got to be the right logs, and so bringing them into the space and offering what we're offering now is the next step for getting folks much closer there.
Yeah, absolutely. And then when we, like, I think that, you know, it's funny, I would make this comment saying that the number one use case for observability is the storage admin, right? They just store a bunch of things, right? And not know what to do with this information, right? But having real data, and it's the lifeline of the business. So capturing the right information, the right logs, and what's been incredibly impressive to me about the Chronosphere platform is the unified approach, right? And when you're looking at it, the five big impacts of log data growth, you know, we see cost inflation, we see that there's slower performance, right? Signal to noise, right? Understanding what's happening. But Alok, maybe we could talk a little bit about that. Like when you were rationalizing this and saying logs is the direction we want to go and you're selling it to the company and saying this is really what customers are looking for, why did you go in this direction?
Well, first and foremost, I think Bill sort of highlighted this. Logs aren't going away, and they're never going to go away. There's been stories about how people will reduce their dependence on logs. So first and foremost, most companies still heavily depend on logs. So we had to and wanted to and needed to offer something that was compelling in their space of logging. Moreover, it's not just about offering a logging offering, just another one, because there's many others out there. The key thing was that many customers just generally struggle with the costs of logging. And so our goal was not just offer a logging solution, offer them those insights into how they can manage those costs, and that really brought it together. And so our platform is complete when we have logs also, but also control as part of our logs, or controlling costs or controlling volumes as part of our logs.
I mean, that makes complete sense to me. I understand that from that perspective.
Sure.
I'm just kind of curious, Bill, why are other vendors that do logging, why are they not managing doing more about it?
I think it's a sensitive topic. I think part of it is that the business model has been, along with logs, but also traces and metrics, collect everything. We've been in this environment of collect everything. And now it's about measuring value, because as companies are scaling out, as there's hyperscaling, that volume is becoming massive.
Yeah.
And so cost is becoming a factor. And then the thing about cost is, how do I value, or how do I understand the value that telemetry is giving me to make sure that I'm collecting the right things, and the things I am collecting are actually tied back to value I'm getting out of the platform. And so, as Alok mentioned, that's what we're doing with the logs piece. We already do that with traces and metrics, but it's about getting that value measurement out there and showing that that's an important component of it versus just collecting everything and then sort of figuring out how to deal with it later when the bill comes.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, this is something that we're hearing in our research. We're seeing that being proactive versus reactive is key. It's critical, right? You have to have that actionable insight. With all this said, you know, there's a lot of observability companies out there, right? There's a lot of different ways to do observability, right? And when I look at it, you know, organizations are either, you know, not mature at all or very mature. Chronosphere has some major differentiation. What is it? What is it? And Bill, let's start with you. Like, what do you think about the major difference? Because I know what it is from the briefings, but I'd like to hear from you.
I think one of the biggest ones is what I just mentioned, which is really around giving that control back to the customer.
Yeah.
Letting them understand what the value of the telemetry and the logs that they're putting into the platform is really returning for them.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And tracing that back to the reason they're doing observability to begin with. If you're a large organization, hopefully your observability strategy is tying back to your business strategy, right? If it's to improve your NPS score, if it's to improve revenue, you need metrics to help you drive to that. You got to get the right metrics, and understanding all of that and the value that each of those metrics is bringing to your overall strategy is important. And so that's a big differentiator for us. We provide you with the ability to understand that value. I worked with developers for years. They tend to get FOMO. They want to collect everything.
Yes.
And you know, they've been burned. They have a lot of experience that tells them to do that.
Yeah.
We give them, and the central observability teams, for example, the data, meta on your meta, to say, okay, I know you wanted 5,000 metrics, you're using 100.
Right, right.
Right?
Yeah, so. I mean, that's important. I think it's absolutely important. I think the other thing, I'll kind of think about it from this perspective. In our research, we see that 75% of organizations that responded to our study said that they use between 6 and 15 different tools for observability. 6 and 15 different tools. And in 2025, the 54% of those organizations indicated that they want to move to more of a unified view. So when I was asked about differentiation, that's one of the cool things I think about Chronosphere is you have logs, you have all the stuff that you're doing here, which is awesome, but talk a little bit about that unified approach, because you can take those different platforms and tie it together.
Yeah, I mean, look, we see that as well when we see our customers. There's tons of customers who have many, many different tools for observability, at least 3, as you said, many, many more. And our core principle outside of cost control, which Bill mentioned, is the ability to unify, and unification is an action, but really what we're talking about is making developers more efficient when they're trying to troubleshoot an incident or something like that. So logs is now an integral part of that platform overall in order to achieve that goal, which is developer efficiency. How do you make a developer most efficient? If they had 16 different tools and they could still remain efficient, I don't think this would have been a problem.
Right.
But the fact that they're not efficient is what we also solve and is another big differentiator for us when customers have tons of different tools.
Yeah, and you also work with your ecosystem too, right? So like if there's a bespoke solution that some organizations are using, you meet the customer where they are in their journey, which is something else I found that was interesting, because like if they're using an OTel kind of solution and you're using that telemetry data as well, you can kind of incorporate that into your solution as well. Is that fair?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I mean, this goes to the core of who we are as a company. I guess a third differentiator in that in the way we're talking about this, we always see ourselves integrating with the rest of the open source community or proprietary vendors where it makes sense. So the fact that you know someone might be using an OTel collector sending us data, customers don't have to change what they do when they're sending us all this stuff. We will naturally integrate, we've built the product such that it naturally integrates with everything that's generally out there. It's also becoming a bit of an expectation on a vendor like us that I don't think we can really survive if we didn't, but that's something that we do, and we do it pretty well across the board. You just mentioned OTel, but there's tons of other standards we support.
Of course.
And I think going to those more open source standards is making it easier to get real results out of tools like Chronosphere, because if you're using an open source platform like OTel, your metrics, your traces are tied together much more cleanly. Your logs are much easier to correlate to all of the other great things you're seeing on that single platform that pulls it all together.
Right, no, that makes a lot of sense. At least from the perspective of using what the prospect that you're talking to is used to using, right? So they're using a certain tool stack or tech stack, they can figure out how to incorporate it into your solution. That's my next question, I guess. Bill, I'll ask you this question.
Yeah.
It's like, when you know, I talk to organizations, and there's a little bit of a struggle of saying, we love to do observability, we really don't know how to get started. Like, it's a hard thing. We do alerting now, we do some, maybe a little bit of logging, but a little bit of monitoring, but we don't know how to like incorporate this to make this more mature. What would you recommend to organizations?
I think you have to start with a strategy, and I think that without a strategy, you wind up going to picking a tool, you wind up thinking about it more from a component level, which some enterprise still do that. They start to think about, I have a product, I want to measure it, and they start with, here's a database, here's a cloud instance, here's this and here's that, instead of thinking about the whole picture as a service and how a user might be impacted. But a strategy really gets you to think about what am I trying to solve, right? I mentioned, you know, revenue, conversion rates, NPS, all of the business sort of initiatives. How do you tie your observability into that? How do you tie then things like a methodology for what I'm going to collect, whether it be metrics, traces, or logs? How are you going to get buy-in within your organization for why we're doing this when everybody's got a million things on their plate already? So it really is, to be short about it, a strategy, and you know, we could talk for hours about
Of course. No, I like that, but I do want to ask the question, because a lot of times the devils are in the details, right? And if you look at it from a product perspective, if somebody was to say, well, I have a strong technical bench, we can figure this out ourselves, we can do it all ourselves. We don't need to have a wrapper solution to do it. I personally think that's the wrong direction. Why do you, what would you recommend somebody doing if they were saying, hey, we can do it ourselves?
I've seen many of my customers have been in this space where they're trying to decide between self-hosting, home growing, or going with a vendor. I think it all comes down to where do they want to spend their time. I don't make a recommendation of go with us. I think that's a very wrong recommendation to make, because it's a personal choice, or a company has to make a choice for itself. If they're optimizing for hyper low cost that no vendor could provide, I think the option is to go self-host. But there's always the opportunity cost they have to always understand, and it's about making sure they understand the opportunity cost. And highlighting what we've seen, you know, we see several customers in our careers in this industry, we see even more customers, not rather than just working with one company, with one vendor. But what we've seen across many, many of these customer conversations is that opportunity cost. And just always highlighting that opportunity cost that they're going to be making, and helping them give the information to make that choice in an informed fashion. I don't think I can ever really change somebody's mind if their heart is set on it. I think that's the most difficult thing a human being could do, is change somebody's mind. But giving them the data to help them understand what their future might look like. Now, we've also therefore seen what we use as data points to give them that information is to tell them, look, what we've seen with vendors who've moved away from that separate tools or self-hosting option onto a product like Chronosphere, for example, is because they got tired of managing things. So those data points help make that opportunity cost clear when they want to make that choice. However, I never push them in a direction.
Yeah, that makes sense. So let me ask you this then. A year from now, when we're sitting here having the same conversation, you know, we're at OSS next year at this time, what do you see the future of logs and observability, and where is it going?
I'll need a couple of data points, and then I'll hand it over to Bill.
Sure.
Couple of things that are happening, they will always continue to grow. I think that's one standard, normal thing to expect, which is data volumes will continue to grow, and they might grow exponentially. OTel is becoming a standard, slowly but surely, or quickly depending on who you speak with, but in a good way, is becoming a standard. And I would say the third thing, and I'll hand it over to Bill in a second, is there was this belief that logs would vanish. Yeah. That has not happened, and it's not going to happen. And I think those are the realities that I live within. Cost, standardization through tooling and OTel, and they're here to stay.
Makes sense. Bill, last word.
I will plus one everything he said. I'll say that I think that when it comes to the DIY approach, I agree with Alok. We don't push people there, but I think people, as we talk next year, I think we'll find more people are realizing that they'd rather spend money on innovation, and observability becomes more of a utility that you just need to have in-house capabilities that is maybe not something you build and manage yourself.
That makes a lot of sense. Well, I want to thank both of you for joining me today. This has been really, really great. I love having you on the desk here. It's awesome talking about this. Chronosphere is always I'm a huge fan. I think it's awesome. I love where you're going with the product. I want to thank the audience here for watching. I'm Paul Nashawaty, and I'm coming to you live from the show floor at Open Source Summit North America 2025. Thank you for watching theCUBE, the leading source of tech news.